I am here with, I guess we can say, the one and only
Hysteria.
Hysteria, what's your name?
Jacob Reiser.
What game do you play?
Halo 4.
And what game would do you live, breathe, eat, and shit, sleep for?
I want to say Halo 4, but I miss the old Halos.
Have you had a chance to play Halo 4 before yesterday?
The only other time I got to play it was at PAX, because they had it available to the public there, but other than that, I haven't.
Again, you guys are now in Winners Round 3, is that right?
Yeah.
Do you know who you play next?
No idea.
Okay, so what's your impression so far with Halo? After seeing it so much better than Reach, what do you like about it?
I'd say at this point it's better than Reach. It's hard to tell at this point. I mean, it'd probably take like a month on the game to really have a good opinion on it and whether or not it competes with the other Halos, but it's fun at this point, so that's pretty important.
That Nate and Alumni both won two of the FFAs that were shown, and I believe someone else won the first one. But how do you feel about having your guys win the FFAs and obviously be teaming with them and now making it to Winners Round 3?
Well, it definitely brings a lot of confidence to those two players, because they feel like, and that's really important. I mean, I always knew they were going to do good, so it just, you know, I guess reinstates the fact that they're going to destroy. But I mean, definitely having those two win, it's more of their mindset that it affects than the rest of the team.
Some of the speculation that goes along with them having an early advantage on the plane, I mean, would you say that does play somewhat of a factor or gives them maybe a little bit of an edge or advantage?
People who play the game on flashed Xboxes or anything like that definitely have an advantage. I mean, maybe not in the shooting aspect, because I mean, it's not that much different from Reach, but just the map awareness and
Halo still Halo?
Yeah, as far as the shooting goes, but there's like 100% there's an advantage.
How do you feel about it being here at MLG?
Well, it's, I guess, a sigh of relief that we get to come again, but I mean, our main stage isn't what it used to be, but I guess we kind of have to build back up.
They got organized sitting going on out here.
I guess we have to build back up the trust with MLG that we can bring in the money. So I guess we'll see for the next event.
Was it just maybe not enough community involvement? I know that MLG spoke briefly on maybe viewer numbers not being there too much, right, with some previous Halo games. Do you feel like that maybe falls back on the community a lot when it, or at least for the time it wasn't on MLG?
Not at all. It's just people didn't have fun playing Reach, so they didn't play it, so they didn't come to tournaments.
So they didn't promote it, they didn't do anything just because of the fact that they didn't enjoy playing, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I mean, you're not gonna fly across the country to go to a tournament to play a game that you don't like playing, so the numbers of like the teams dropping off from like 250 selling out in a day or two to like 50 teams at Providence or whatever, it's just definitely just no one liked playing Reach.
Outside of gaming, what else do you like to do? I mean, what makes up Hysteria? What else does he do besides competitive gaming?
Well, right now I'm in college, and other than that, I guess I like going to the gym a lot.
What are you studying?
I just started, so I'm taking math and Englishes. I haven't decided on a major yet.
Gaming industry, any development endeavors?
I'm probably going to end up going into something in the computer field, so I mean, it could end up something to do with gaming.
Say an MLG staff person came up to you and they said, hey, what's one thing that we could improve about our events? What do you think that would be?
Bring the bleachers back.
Bring the bleachers back.
Main stage from 2010, from however many years they had it, like 5 years, because that definitely got the crowd hyped up and just made the experience better.
You know, one of the things we've been hearing a lot is people talking about some kind of app or some kind of feature where you can register on MLG and they'll text you when your match starts in order to kind of minimize delays and things like that, or players not showing up, or you not having to wait an hour and a half or two. Do you think that would be a good idea in order to kind of have better or more organized scheduling?
It would definitely help out.
But it's not too bad, doesn't affect you that much?
I mean, the schedules are available. It's not that, it's just the delays, but most of that's due to the stream, which they can't really do anything about. It's not like they come into the tournaments expecting to have a stream delay.
So. You hate MLG?
I love MLG.
What do you love about MLG?
The whole experience, just being in the venue. Not just playing Halo, but getting to watch all the other games too.
So you support it as much as you love playing it?
Yeah, I went to Anaheim even though there was no Halo.
Any shout-outs, any mentions, Twitter plugs, social network plugs? Sponsors?
You can follow me on Twitter at Jacob Hysteria. Shout-out to my girlfriend, Ellen, and big thanks to Mason for letting me play Reach at his house the last 3 weeks. So, yeah, that should be it.
Once again, this is With Hysteria. Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate you taking the time to do an interview with us. And good luck the rest of the tournament.